hit that subscribe,
hit that
comment, notification bell, man. Y'all know what's up, Fable, let's go. Show some love. Tell them what Fable, I'm here to enable. We're breaking out raps, consider the table. We put it together on the back of a cable. Crew squad ripping, better take another angle. When I get up on the mic, they know I'm like Kurt Angle. I make you tap if you ever go a Fable. Break it out, boss, better catch some lingo. This is what we do, don't like a distant rainbow. Ha, hit that notification.
Yo, what up, man?
You know what it is, it's good.
Fable Squad, and we continue on the music to be murdered by train, right? And murdered by Slim Shady, on Slim Shady train. Let's go, man. Next track, Stepdad, by the one and only. Let's see what he's got, man. Let's see what he's got. I've never heard this track. Obviously, I'm saving all of them before I react to them. I want to react to them and react them first time. So yeah, man. Let's go. Stepdad.
Hey yo, what's the song about?
My stepdad.
See if this ever happened to you.
My stepdad.
One thing that sticks in my craw, when I was six and I saw my stepfather hitting my mom, socked her right in her eyeball. I'm starting to think I'm psychotic with all the pictures I draw. Ish that I've already witnessed is probably twisting my thoughts. All I can hear is drama with mom and him. I can always hear him arguing.
He's going back from when he was six, and the way he's actually constructing the song, I can see what he's trying to do. He's trying to actually appeal to the kids who actually feel like this. Now, this is the kind of M that used to appeal to me when I was a kid. You know what I mean? It was that like sort of angry M that literally took charge and took things into his own fucking hands. You know what I mean? And this is basically what he's saying about his stepdad. And how many kids come from abusive homes where stepdads do stupid shit? Okay, let's just go.
Any witness is probably twisting my thoughts. All I can hear is drama with mom and him. I can always hear him arguing down the hallways. The walls are thin, so the noise is starting to feel like the norm. Our dog pissed on the carpet. He's so hard, doctors had to put it down. He killed my chihuahua, this mother.
Whoa. He killed my chihuahua. Fucking, what kind of evil prick is this? Okay. Outside I look like I'm calm, but inside I'm like a ticking time bomb. You know what I mean? And people who come from like abusive homes and families like that will relate to that feeling. You know what I mean? When you look like you're doing okay, when you go to school, you put on this facade and whatever else, but you're a ticking time bomb. There's only a point in time until you actually literally just want to set the whole fucking place on fire. You know what I mean? Your house, not the school, of course. Let's go.
Last night he said I left the kitchen light on, but he walked in there this morning and purposely flipped it. I saw him. Hickory switched to my bottom. I counted 69 times. He swatted me with it. I cried. He just started hitting me harder. God, I wish I could just jar him if I could get my weight up, but I'm just a second grader. This book is bigger than I am, but I've been reading at school about this shit called liquid cyanide. I'm fantasizing.
Oh my god. Okay, so obviously he's beating him. Again, told you, a very relatable track to a lot of people that are in this sort of situation. And then you start having those thoughts of, how do I kill this bastard? I can't beat him. He's bigger than me, stronger than me. I mean, how do I get rid of this guy? Obviously, never do that. Rather just report, if you are a youngster, rather just report this situation to police or whatever else. Never take it into your hands. But I can see he's like, I read about this liquid cyanide stuff. Well, then whatever, this guy's gonna get some fucking liquid cyanide.
At night when he's sleeping at just the right time, sneak up with a lethal injection and put him down like they did to my dog. I'm talking euthanasia, like kids in Taiwan. This is like Saigon. Neighbors call police on him. So many battery charges. This dude's like lithium ion.
Neighbors call the police on him. He's got so many battery charges. It's like lithium ion. Batteries, lithium ion and batteries. Oh my god. Told you, man. End with his words. But a lot of kids will relate to this. There are so many kids out there that live in abuse. Even if it's not stepdad, even if it's a dad, a lot of kids will relate to the abusiveness that happens in homes. It happens. It's out there. It happens.
Dudes like lithium ion, then mom and him let bygones. Just be eggshells I walk and just try not to piss this guy off. But this is why I...
That's the worst situation in the world, man. I was in that situation where you consistently have to walk on eggshells, man. You know what I mean? Because you're living in such an unstable fucking life, unstable family, with an unstable father. You know what I mean? Where everything just feels like something's going to erupt. A minute from now, something's going to fucking happen. You know what I mean? Where the house just starts getting broken to pieces and shit like that. You know what I mean? I know what he's saying.
Not to piss this guy off, but this is why I
hate my stepdad. So tonight I'm saying bye-bye stepdad.
So this year I'm going into the fifth and I'm tall. I'm 5'6" on my block. I'm the toughest kid, but I got way bigger fish to fry, which is why I'm trying to get this fish to fly off the handle and wait for the fist to fly to put this guy in a pine box. He's always looking.
Oh my god, he's waiting for this guy to fly off the handle so I can put a fist through his jaw and put him in a pine box. Oh my god, okay. He's plotting over here.
Chaos for tonight.
Wait, let me go back before I get shouted at.
Box. He's always looking for chaos. Well, tonight I've cooked up a plan. So this Christmas I got some color books and some crayons. I'm laying on the floor in the living room with some friends. Coloring, he walks by and kicks my arm and goes oops and just laughs. I yell for mom, and as she's rushing to my defense, I stood up and said, oh, you punk, and I took off and ran to my...
Oh my god, he got some balls, man. It's like, fuck you, punk, and then he took off and ran. Obviously plotting something in his room. Okay.
Bedroom as I fled, knowing this would hit the fan. Slammed the door and hid behind it with an aluminum bat. He kicked it in, I swung it hard as I could at his head. His noodle went splat, he fell right at the foot of my bed.
Oh my god, he stood behind the door with an aluminum bat, and then when he fucking kicked the door in, he swung it at his head. And he fell at the foot, like his noodle went in. His noodle got smashed, man. Oh my god, that's a little bit unnecessary for a kid. I mean, that's going to be a trauma situation that you're going to have to need counseling for the next couple of months as a kid. You know what I mean? But then again, abuse is that at the end of the day. So what I love about what he's doing here is that he's storytelling, and he storytells so easily. And the beat is quite a rough beat, as it should be, and it's quite a pacey beat. But he's so good at storytelling on this beat, it's crazy.
He fell right at the foot of my bed. I'm a little bit scared, but my anger's overtook in the fear. I threw down the bat and just started whooping his ass. Beat him with my bare hands. The big bad wolf ain't so bad. Ding dong, the bully is dead. The bully finally gets his.
Yeah, the bully finally gets in, man. It gets his, man. He fucking, after he fucking knocked his noodle, right? He then just jumped on him and just kept hitting him with his bare hands. You know what I mean? But the bully got his own, man. The bully got his own. You know what I mean? I'm saying.
Till he pissed enough to fill a 2-liter with. Then buried him next to my dog. And if I go to juvie for this, I'ma tell him.
I'll bury him next to my dog, but if I go to juvie for this, bury him next to my dog. You killed my dog, you can fucking die next to him.
Next to my dog, and if I go to juvie for this, I'ma tell him
I hate my stepdad. So tonight I'm saying bye-bye stepdad. Cause I hate my stepdad. So tonight I'm saying bye-bye stepdad.
You know, this is what Eminem's always been really, really good at, and especially back in the day. This is what I loved about Eminem back in the day, man. And this is why he was so relatable back in the day, is because he used to do this kind of storytelling. You know what I mean? He used to do this kind of storytelling. This is how a lot of kids feel in certain families, and this is what this music is supposed to be for that. And it's not to say that they must go and do what he's saying over here. But it's all about the anger. Eminem, I found when I was younger, always said the things that I was thinking. You know what I mean? The things that you could never say in public because it's a little bit too crazy to say in public. It was too controversial or too crazy. But I was thinking those things. You know what I mean? And that's why he was so relatable. That's why he connected with me so much as a kid. It's because fucking hell, I was thinking that. You know what I mean? And Em just said that. You know what I mean? So like, I'm obviously not the only one. I'm not the only one in these situations. I'm not the only, you know, there's somebody I can relate to who's actually famous. So that's what Eminem was about. And that's what Eminem is doing really well with this album, though, is he's encompassing all things. He's encompassing the storytelling, the lyrical spitting that he always does, new type music with new type beats. It's a very experimental, you know what I mean? So he's murdering very different type of things here. I like it. I like this album. So guys, you let me know what you think about this song, man. Drop a comment down below. Like it if you like it. Dislike it if you don't like it. But other than that, this is very good, man. This is very good. It's not my favorite on the album, but super relatable. I don't relate to this right now. But yeah, it's a very, very, very good track. Just with regards to his storytelling. So, right guys, wherever you are in the world, man, I hope you're having a super awesome day, whether it be evening, night, or morning. It doesn't matter. I hope you have a killer day. Stay safe. Love each other. Peace.